The Philippine Olympic Committee vows to continue support for pole vaulter EJ Obiena despite Patapa's decision to expel him from its training pool. The POC says it will still try to get Obiena to represent the Philippines at the Asian and SEA Games this year and at the 2024 Paris Olympics.
We, not as a POC president, as a congressman, ibang mga legislators, we gave budget to PSC. Teka, para gamitin mo yung sa atleta, sa sports development, etc. Now, if PSC will not, definitely POC will look for a private funding for him. And question lang naman doon yung training. The D-Day, the competition itself, madali nang ihanap yun. Ang question lang doon yung mahabang period ng training and qualifying, no? So who will bankroll that? The POC will look for that.
The POC earlier declared Patapa President Philip Wico persona non grata for supposedly harassing Obiena.
Filipino Olympic pole vaulter EJ Obiena saddened but not surprised by the recommendation of the Philippine Athletics Track and Field Association to expel him from the national team. Patapa is also mulling the Estafa case against Obiena over his alleged failure to pay his coach. Obiena says he is prepared to face any charge against him and hopeful he will have a fair day in court. He believes Patapa has now made its intentions clear that they just want him out of the Philippine team. He thanks everyone who backed him in his feud with Patapa chief Philip Wico, stressing that he is competing for the flag and not for the Patapa leadership.
The Philippine Election Commission dismisses another petition challenging the candidacy of presidential frontrunner Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. The petition filed by Tiburcio Marcos alleged Marcos Jr. is an imposter and that the real son of the former dictator had died in 1975. COMELEC spokesman James Jimenez says the petition was dismissed before the new year, though a copy of the resolution has yet to be released. The poll body earlier junked a petition filed by independent presidential contender Danilo Lihay-Lihay for the cancellation of Marcos Jr.'s certificate of candidacy. Several other COC cancellation and disqualification cases remain pending with the COMELEC.
An outlier. That's how the Philippine Commission on Elections sees the petition filed by the ruling PDP Laban Party to reopen the filing of candidacies and postpone the printing of ballots. COMELEC spokesperson James Jimenez says it's unusual to ask for an extension months after the deadline has lapsed. He also explained the consequences should the COMELEC en banc approve the petition.
If you open it up now, you can expect that a whole bunch of other people are going to start filing again. And when they do that, then we're going to have to go through the entire process from day one, which means that you're setting back the clock effectively at least 3 months. And we're not even talking about the printing of the ballots yet, right? Again, it's ridiculous to assume that if this is done, only one party will take advantage of this. Everyone will take advantage of this.
This foul-mouthed tirade of Philippine senatorial aspirant Larry Gadon earns him his second suspension as a lawyer. The Philippine Supreme Court indefinitely suspended Gadon on Tuesday, following a month since his viral video went out. Gadon directed the expletives against journalist Raisa Robles in December. He was defending presidential aspirant Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. against Robles' tweet about Marcos' tax evasion cases. Gadon is running for Senate in the next year's polls. His party, the Kilusang Bagong Lipunan, has Marcos as its standard bearer. Gadon gets an extended holiday break, as the court says, the suspension is in effect until lifted. He was also told to explain why he should not be disbarred. Gadon was previously suspended in 2019, also over his use of offensive language.
The Supreme Court shortens this month's bar exams to 2 days. That's amid concerns over the effects of the Omicron COVID-19 variant and Typhoon Odette. Now, the long-delayed exams will now be held on January 23 and 25, instead of the original schedule, 4 days. The SC also reduced the coverage of the exams. From 8 subjects, the coverage is now down to just 4. Bar examinees are asked to begin self-quarantine by January 9th. The High Court also says it decided to proceed with the exams despite the pandemic situation to meet the demand for new lawyers.